हेलो स्टूडेंट, वेलकम टू एसएसटी क्लास। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द रिमेनिंग पैराग्राफ ऑफ द टॉपिक योर नाइन्थ नंबर चैप्टर एक्सप्लोरिंग इंडिया। सो 44 सिकरी इज ए न्यू टॉपिक विल डिस्कस टुडे। 44 सिकरी इज 37 किलोमीटर अवे फ्रॉम आगरा। द टाउन वॉज बिल्ड कंप्लीटली इन रेड सैंडस्टोन। द स्लोपिंग लेवल्स ऑफ फातेपुर वेयर कनेक्टेड विथ टेरास वेयर डिफरेंट बिल्डिंग्स वेयर बिल्ट लाइक जामी मस्जिद, बुलंद दरवाजा, तोम्बो ऑफ शेख सालिम, चिश्ती पंच महल एंड अनूप तालो। द टाउन हैड अ मोस्ट वेल प्लान ड्रेनेज एंड वाटर सप्लाई सिस्टम। द फातेपुर सिकरी इज वेल कनेक्टेड, वेल डेवलप्ड एंड वेल established, built so many architect like Jami Masjid, Bulan Darwaza, Tomb of Sikh, Salim Chishti, Panch Mahal, Anup Talwa, all this type. The town had a most well-planned drainage and water supply. So basically in different towns, we need to plan better pass the drainage water. So there is a well drain plant drainage system and water supply system should needed there. It is very convenient to move around Agra as a taxi, auto rickshaw, cycle rickshaw, tangas are easily. Auto rickshaw you have seen, taxi you have seen, cycle rickshaw also you have seen, and tangas, this type of cart, and this is tangas are basically like Patna and Agra type cities were looking and is looking also. People are using this easily available here. Diesel or petrol vehicles are not allowed to ply in the Taj Mahal area to preserve the beauty of the great monument. Only population pollution free battery operated vehicle, tangas, camel cart and rickshaws are allowed here. So in Taj Mahal area there is no allow diesel and petrol vehicle, and here only to preserve the beauty of the great monument allowed to that is battery operated vehicles, tangas, camel cart and riksha are allowed here. Okay, so here look, do you know Akbar the Mughal emperor shifted his court from Agra to Fatehpur Sikri from 13 years in honor of the Sufi saint Sheikh Salim Chishti who lived here. Okay, Akbar is the Mughal emperor. Okay, Akbar is the Mughal emperor and shifted his court from Agra to Fatehpur Sikri for 13 years in honor of the Sufi saint Sheikh Salim Chishti who lived here. And now come to the next, the visit to Manipur situated in northeast part of India. Manipur is known as the jewel of India due to its natural beauty. Yes, Manipur is the really jewel of India and it has the vast natural beauty. The population is the mixture of many tribes, each with a unique culture. Manipur is well connected to the major cities of India by air. The airport is in Imphal, the capital of Manipur. The airport is in Imphal, and Imphal is the capital city of Manipur. Capital city of Manipur, and Manipur is not very well connected with other part of the country via railways. The nearest railway junctions are at Silchar in Assam and Dispur in Nagaland. So this Manipur's nearest railway station is in Assam at Silchar and Dimapur in Nagaland. Manipur has a good network of national and state highway. Okay, Manipur is the good network of national and state highway, and this is the Manipur area. Look, this is Nagaland, this is Assam areas, and this is Mizoram, and all this is the Manipur areas. Okay, Manipur areas. So look, Manipur offers many tourist attractions like Sri Govindaji Temple, Loknath Temple, Sri Govindaji Temple, and Loknath Lake, Kibul Lamjao Floating National Park, Shahid Minar, etc. are famous, and these are the things attracting to the tourists. So do you know here, Imphal is 15 kilometers from Nagaland. So Imphal is 215 kilometers from Nagaland, and Imphal is the capital city of Manipur state. So Sri Govindaji Temple is here. The temple was a hub of cultural activity during the times of the Maharajas. It is located close to the royal palaces. It has two domes and raised congregation hall to keep the deities in their sacred place, aloof and high. The congregation hall means where a place many priests and the people who sit in a place, and they can take decision, they can decide what to do, how to manage all the things. Congregation hall to keep the deities in their sacred, or congregation hall is basically here in temple, the place where the priest were. Just keeping the deities in that sacred place, aloof and high. So congregation hall means jahan pe bhagwan ko jis ghar mein rakha jata hai aur wahan pe baitha bhi ja sakta hai, is type ka ek hall, bahut bada hall tha isi temple mein. Okay, Laktak Lake and Sandra Island. Laktak Lake is the largest freshwater lake in eastern India and is a big attraction for fishing. This is Laktak Lake. This is Laktak Lake. This is big attraction for fishing. Look here, people have divided this lake in a different part, and they are cultivating the fishery. The tourists can enjoy their stay in the beautiful bungalows situated close to the Sandra Island. The Laktak Lake is also world famous for a great variety of orchids. Laktak Lake is famous, world famous for a great variety of orchid. The Kibul Lamjao National Park. Kibul Lamjao National Park. It is the only floating national park in the world. Floating national park. Look here. This is Kibul Lamjao National Park. It is the only floating national park in the world. It is 53 kilometers from Imphal. 53 kilometers from Imphal. Imphal is the capital city of the Manipur. The park is composed of massive mass of floating weeds. Look here. these are weeds. The fishermen live in floating huts. The fishermen live in floating hut. These are the floating hut. The park is famous for the endangered bro antar deer of Manipur Sangai. Manipur Sangai. This is the park for the park area where endangered bro antar deer of Manipur Sangai is famous here. So now we visit to Mysore. Mysore, the historical city of Karnataka, is rich in art and culture. Okay, by visiting Mysore, the historical city of Karnataka, is rich in art and culture. It is a city of palaces, garden, and sacred temples. Okay, Mysore is located in Karnataka, and it's Karnataka's is capital city is Bangalore. So Mysore is located in Karnataka, and Mysore is a rich art and culture city. This is the map of Karnataka. Okay, Karnataka political map. From this side Maharashtra, this side Andhra Pradesh, then RBNC, Tamil Nadu, Kerala. Okay, so do you know here? Mysore was called Mahesore in ancient time. Mahesore in ancient time. The nearest airport is at Bengaluru. It is 139 kilometers from Mysore. The city is well connected by road to and railways with Bengaluru, Chennai, and many other cities of South India, connected with road. Mysore to Bengaluru, Chennai, and many other cities of South India. Okay, so do you know here? Passenger ship service are available from Port Blair to Chennai, Calcutta, and Visakhapatnam. From here, okay, Port Blair. Islands, okay, for Indira Point, already abolished by water cover, and Andaman Nicobar Islands, Port Blair here, the port, the ship service is direct connected to from Mysore to Port Blair, Chennai, Port Blair to Chennai, Calcutta, and Visakhapatnam also. The Mysore palaces, it was the residence of the Wadayar rulers. The palaces is now a museum that houses great treasures of paintings, jewelry, royal costumes, and other items. So Mysore residence of the Wadayar's rulers, the palaces is now a museum that houses great treasures. So this is the palaces where the king or the Wadayar rulers were living here in ancient time, and now this is converted into museum, and that house great treasures of painting, jewelry, royal costume, and other items. The golden royal elephant throne, the Darbar Hall, and the Kalyan Mandap wedding hall are the main attraction here. So Kalyan Mandap means the wedding hall are the main attraction here in this palaces. So do you know here, the Mysore palaces has a unique French clock every hour per day by miniature soldiers is displayed. The beating drums by the soldier mark the second and a bugle mark of minutes. The royal elephant throne contains 84 kilograms of 24 carat gold. The royal elephant throne contains 84 kilogram of 24 carat gold made by this 24 carat gold. Okay, then come to next Vrindavan Garden. The famous garden is located on the terrace of the Krishna Raj Sagar Dam in Mysore across River Kaveri. And the River Kaveri is famous in Karnataka because this river and dispute is continuously going on from by with Tamil Nadu. Okay, river dispute. So Kaveri River, River Kaveri is in Mysore. It was built in 1932 by Krishna Raj Wadiyar IV, a great lover of gardens. The musical fountain are the special attraction that showcase a wonderful harmony of water, color, and music every evening. So, Vrindavan Garden, this is made by the Krishna Raj Wadiyar IV, and he was the and lover of the garden. And musical fountains are the special attraction that showcase the wonderful harmony of water, watercolor looking so nicely, watercolor and music every evening. Then preserving our heritage. The whole of India is a home to great treasure in the form of historical monuments and natural beauty. They must be preserved to tell the tales of our glorious past to our future generation. Our neglect has already destroyed some beautiful example of our heritage. However, serious efforts are now being made to restore their beauty. It is the responsibility of each and every person to look after these palaces of Indian culture heritage and not disfigure them. Monuments have no voice, so you must speak out for them. So the whole of India is a home and great treasure. Yes, the whole of India is a home to great treasure, treasures in the form of historical monument. Yes, we have many historical monuments and natural beauty. They must be preserved. It's our duty, our responsibility, and the government's responsibility and duty to preserve to the all historical monument and natural beauty of the nation, and the tales of our glorious past to our future generation, and it will study, it will help to know the information to the future generation. Our neglect has already destroyed. We should not neglect. We should not ignore. We have to aware. We have to carefully maintain the monuments and natural beauty, historical monuments and natural beauty. We should properly preserve. Then it will preservable to future. However, seriously efforts are now being made to restore their beauty. It is responsibility of each and every person look after these palaces of Indian culture and heritage, not disfigure them. So not only the government, one and all, and each and every person has responsibility to preserve these historical monuments and natural beauty of the nation in the sustainable way. The monuments have no voice, so you must speak out of them. Okay, monuments have no voice. They never ask you what to do and what to not to do, but we have to preserve them. So do you know here? There are three types of heritage: natural heritage, built heritage, and living heritage. Natural heritage are water, land, lake, all these things. And built heritage are like monuments, and the living heritage are here. We must take a lesson from Poland in preserving history. Poland is one of the example of the world to preserve the it's a historical monument in the monument. So in the Warsaw National Museum, Poland, three photographs hang side by side. The caption below them say Warsaw 1939, Warsaw 1945, and Warsaw today. The first and the last picture are almost identical. The photograph in the center shows a devastated Warsaw. So at the end of the Second World War, the police people, despite not having many resources, lovingly rebuilt their city exactly as it was before the war. Just look how they are aware and they are responsible to preserve the history. So we have finished these things today to explain some video. Next video we'll make for a question answer. So for today, thank you to all of you and hope you will go in the better way and prepare well at home. Okay, thank you.